I'm John Clark. We're at the RhinoAg factory in Gibson City, Illinois. The TS10s are coming off the line right now, and I've grabbed one. We've got it over at the shop. We're going to go take a look at it. We're going to do a pre-delivery and setup video.
In this video, we're going to go through the setup and pre-delivery procedure for the Rhino TS10 Rotary Cutter. Anytime we set up a rotary cutter, we want to make sure we use the customer's tractor or a tractor of comparable size and drawbar height. First off, we'll want to prepare the tractor by checking that tractor hydraulic fluid level and top off if necessary. We're going to measure the drawbar length and position it as per the owner's manual instructions for the driveline used. Measure from the end of the PTO shaft to the center of the tractor drawbar hitch pin hole. Make sure it's 14 inches. This adjustment's necessary for optimal driveline travel. Once we have the tractor set up, we'll want to inspect the cutter for any loose or missing hardware. Here I'm just giving a visual inspection, looking for anything that's out of place or maybe mispositioned. Now we're ready to hook up the tractor. We're going to back it up and position it in place so we can drop a 3/4 by 6 inch bolt along with 2 3/4 flat washers and a 3/4 lock nut to secure the drawbar to the hitch. You'll have to obtain this hardware locally. Next, we'll attach the safety chain. Now that we're hooked up, we'll want to remove and stow the parking jack. Now go back and remove the driveline from the shipping position. At this point, we'll confirm the driveline matches the PTO speed of the cutter. In this case, it's 540 RPM, and we'll do that by visually inspecting the yoke on the end of the driveline. 540 RPM will have 1 3/8 6 splines. Then we're going to install the driveline on the divider gearbox and torque to 170 foot-pounds as per the specification located in the owner's manual. At this point, we'll attach the driveline to the tractor. Make sure you push and pull the driveline back and forth several times to ensure a secure attachment. Time to locate the hydraulic hose. This hose is shipped without a hydraulic tip because of the different tip designs in the industry. Install the correct tip for this application. Now attach the hose to the remote on the tractor. The hydraulic system shipped without oil from the factory at RhinoAg. It'll be necessary to charge this hydraulic system with oil prior to use. We're going to use the tractor to do that. We're going to charge the raise and lower hydraulics and the wing hydraulics before we remove the transport lock bars. When we engage the hydraulics, the cutter will lift up and then the wings will fold in during this procedure. This system will require about 1 gallon of hydraulic oil to fill. Check and repair any hydraulic leaks at this time. Check the hydraulic oil of the tractor too after this procedure. After the hydraulic system is charged, the transport locks can be removed and stowed. There should be little effort to remove the lock bar. Here's a word of caution here. Without any hydraulic oil in this fold system, the wings could come down without warning, so make sure there's no pressure on these bars when you're taking them loose. Make sure there are no obstructions around the cutter and keep all personnel away during this procedure. Once the area is secure, use the tractor hydraulics to unfold the wings. The wings unfold using gravity and fold using hydraulic pressure. The hydraulic system is designed for one hose operation. When lifting the cutter, once the center cylinder reaches full extent, the wings will then raise to transport position. We're going to do this a couple times to make sure all the air is bled out of the system. Now that we've got the cutter unfolded, we're going to raise it to its full extent. Then back out of the tractor and we'll remove the transport lock. Want to make sure the cutter is positioned on a flat level surface. Lower the cutter to rest on all the cylinder stops provided and place tractor hydraulics in float if equipped. If the tractor doesn't have float, just return the lever to neutral. Now we're ready to adjust the cutter. We're going to adjust the cutter fore and aft by using the level rod. To make sure the cutter rests level, I'm going to use a bubble level on top of the gearbox for reference. Here we'll break the jam nut loose and adjust the nut. We're going to adjust this until the cutter is level fore and aft. Once level and when we're satisfied, we'll retighten the jam nut. Now we're ready to adjust the wing. A bubble level can be used for reference here as well. Time to loosen the jam nut on the axle turnbuckle. I'm going to turn that turnbuckle body until the wing is level. This adjustment is used to level the wing side to side. We'll retighten the jam nut. Repeat this adjustment on the other turnbuckle for the opposite wing. Once adjusted, make sure the jam nuts are tight. Back into the tractor again, raise the cutter to full extent. At this point, we're going to add or remove cylinder stop segments on the center hydraulic cylinder to set our desired cut height. Back in the tractor again to lower the cutter down to operating position. Now that we've got the cutter unfolded and set, we want to perform a final hardware inspection and walk around. During the final inspection and walk around, we're going to check the fluid level in the divider gearbox. We'll remove the top plug. Oil should be just below the threads or just trickle out of the hole. We'll reinstall the plug. Now we'll check the oil in the blade gearboxes. These boxes have dipsticks. The oil should be in the hash marks on the dipstick. If we need to top off any gearboxes or we just need extra oil, Rhino uses Lucas Oil 85W140. Now we need to grease the main drive line. Front U-joints. Profile. And rear U-joint. Don't forget the wing drive lines. Front U-joint. Rear U-joint. Profile on both wings. Now we're going to grease the axle pivot points. Now this TS10 cutter is ready for field operation. Once we get to the field, there may be some adjustments to optimize performance, but otherwise we're ready to go mow.